Hi, Josh here, and you're watching 610BOB's Builds. This is part one of a three-part series about hydraulic-assisted steering. Today, we're going to find out what hydraulic-assisted steering is and why you need it. Well, why you want it. You probably don't need it. So if you ever hung around off-roaders, you have probably heard of the term hydro-assist or maybe even full hydro. But what do these terms mean? To understand that, you first must understand what a traditional steering setup is. This is a traditional steering setup. Well, hold on, let's ignore this. And, well, there should be a drank leg here, so let's add that. Here we go. Now it's a normal setup. A steering box, sometimes called a steering gear, rotates a pitman arm. Usually, this arm pushes against a drag link. This pushes against a knuckle, which turns the tire. The tie rod ties the two tires together, so if one turns, the other turns. Full hydraulic steering works a bit differently. Let's get rid of this drag link and unignore the hydraulic ram that pushes against the tie rod. Let's also say we replace the power steering box with this valve. This valve meters the amount of fluid going in and out of your ram. So the more you turn the steering wheel, the more fluid that enters one side of the hydraulic ram, and the more fluid that exits the other side. This is full hydro. The only thing connecting the steering wheel to the axle is a couple of hydraulic hoses. You see this kind of setup on heavy equipment a lot. One reason? Because it's simple. Since you only need two hoses going from the steering wheel to the axle, you can put your steering wheel practically anywhere. For example, this forklift. The steering wheel is here, but the wheel that turns is way back here. This also means that you don't have any rods going from a fixed point on your frame to a wobbly axle. This not only aids in suspension travel, but eliminates bump steer. This is another reason why you see full hydro on dedicated off-road vehicles. In our theoretical full hydraulic setup, we used a standard hydraulic ram, but many off-roaders use a double-ended hydraulic ram. This ram would act as our tie rod, simplifying our setup even more. Which basically means less stuff to break. Also, since all the forces are in line, using this type of ram is stronger than a standard ram setup. And way stronger than a traditional setup. There's one less flimsy rod that can bend. No pitman arm to snap, and no steering box to blow up. The downside? If you lose hydraulic pressure due to a bad pump or your engine being off, you will probably lose steering. I say probably because I don't know if they make a fail-safe steering valve. But if you lose a hose or fluid in your hydraulic system, you will definitely lose steering. Which means it ain't legal. Well, maybe. I did some reading and apparently the legality of full hydro is dependent upon local laws. But it's still a bad idea for a road vehicle. But don't fret, there's a middle ground. It's called hydraulic assisted steering, aka hydro assist. We still have the hydraulic ram, but we also have the drag link and the steering box. We use the valve that's already in the power steering box to control the ram. Since we still have a drag link and a steering box, we still have manual steering. We do lose the simplicity of a full hydraulic setup, but the hydraulic ram reduces the stress on the drag link, pitman arm, and power steering box, which is why a lot of on and off-road vehicles use it. You can buy a bolt-on kit that includes everything you need for hydraulic-assisted steering, but at a cost. Or you can make your own. You just need to get a hydraulic ram, make or buy mounts for the ram, port the power steering box, and get hoses to go from the power steering box to the hydraulic ram. I already made a video showing you how I made the mounts for my hydraulic ram. In the next video, I will show you how to port a power steering box for hydro assist. Then I will explain how to pick your hydraulic ram size and whether or not you need a new power steering pump. Since the ball lead screw can't move up or down, it pulls the piston up or pushes it down, just like a nut on a bolt. This piston is also a rack and the output shaft is a pinion. As the piston moves up and down, it pushes against the teeth of the output shaft.